सर, हियर वी विल डिस्कस फ्यू ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चंस ऑन द लिविंग वर्ल्ड टॉपिक. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन हियर इज, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कांट बी एन इंक्लूसिव डिफाइनिंग कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो फर्स्ट वन इज, सो दे आर आस्किंग अबाउट विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट ए डिफाइनिंग कैरेक्टर ऑफ अ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. मेटाबॉलिज्म, कॉन्शियसनेस, सेलुलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड रिप्रोडक्शन. So among the four, we know that metabolism, consciousness and cellular organization, three of them, they are what we call defining features. Because the metabolism is shown by only living organisms, consciousness is also shown by only living organisms, cellular organization is also found only in the living organism. Reproduction, what it is there, we cannot say determining future, because in some species they are unable to reproduce or non-fertile, such we cannot say them as a living organism, is wrong statement. So even some which are unable to reproduce, then also we can say them as a living organisms. So first three are defining features, where reproduction is not a defining feature. So answer here is, which of the following is the inclusive defining characteristic of living organism? Cannot be defining characteristic andre reproduction. So second, what we have here is second question, all living organisms show spore formation, budding, asexual reproduction and consciousness. So whether all living organisms will show consciousness. So what are these? Spore formation, budding and asexual reproduction. These are different types of sexual reproduction. So where some organisms will be completely sexual reproducing organism, some will be not forming spores, some will be not forming budding, some will be not forming asexual reproduction, they are undergoing sexual reproduction. So all living organism will show the reproduction, but not of same these types what they have given, but all living organisms have consciousness to feel what environmental changes are going to take place in nature. Third question, the only living organism to have a self-consciousness with a well-developed nervous system, like plants, animals, bacteria, human. Only human beings have the self-consciousness. What danger is coming, they can analyze it, right? So plants, they do not have self-consciousness. Not all the animals except humans. Okay, humans have the self-consciousness. Bacteria do not have self-consciousness. So self-consciousness is a characteristic features of human beings. So human being is answer, students. The only living organism to have a self-consciousness is human beings. Next question is, the total number of species that are known and described and degree of variation in life forms is called flora, biodiversity, systematics and biology. So flora means only plants, fauna means only animals, systematics means arrangement of organisms, and biology means study of living organisms. So here they are asking about the total number of species that are known and described, around 1.7 to 1.8 million species which are described. That is what we call it as biodiversity, students. What we call it as biodiversity. The known described organisms on earth is called as biodiversity. Next is, the Systema Naturae was written by Linnaeus, Theophaster, Aristotle and Bentham and Hooker. So Carolus Linnaeus is the first person to classify the organisms into plants and animals, and I have written a book what we call it as Systema Naturae. The Systema Naturae is written by Linnaeus. Theophaster is about the classification of plants, he has written. Aristotle is called as father of biology. Bentham and Hooker has given the classification of angiosperms, students, right? So this natural classification, what we also call is Bentham and Hooker. So this is, they have classified angiosperms. Aristotle, father of biology. Theophaster, what? Aristotle also classified organism into anemia and anemia. Theo Pasteur is called as father of botany. He also classified plants, so plant father of plant taxonomy we call him as. Whereas System and Nature of book is written by Corlys Linnaeus. Next question is, the study of different kinds of organisms, their diversities and relationship among themselves is called biodiversity, systematics, flora and ecology. So it is called as systematics. Systematics nothing but, it's nothing but a like of taxonomy only, where we will study the different kinds of organisms, their diversity and relationship among themselves. That is what we call it as systematics. So arranging them based on their characters in a systematic way, that's what we call it as systematics. It is another term to define taxonomy. So next question is, as we go higher in taxonomic hierarchy, the number of common character increase, the number of common character decrease, the number of common character is unaffected, diversity in the characters decrease. So as I've been explained repeatedly, in a taxonomic hierarchy, andre kramanagatavagi organisms na arrange madidre, what we will have, species, genus, right, family, order, class, right, then phylum, kingdom. So as we move from species to kingdom, the common characters among the organisms will decrease, students. Okay, so as we go higher in the taxonomic hierarchy, the number of common characters goes on decreasing. That is what we call it as, right, the diversity in the living world. What we will see, as we move above in the taxonomic hierarchy, the similarity among the organisms or common characters will decrease. When it will increase? As we move from kingdom to species, it will increase. When we move from species to kingdom, the common characters will decrease. The family that shares the same order along with the Solanaceae. So Malvaceae, Fabaceae, Convolvulaceae, and the Liliaceae. This Convolvulaceae is answer, students, where both of this Solanaceae and Convolvulaceae are grouped together in an order called Poaliaceae. So this families, the Solanaceae and Convolvulaceae, they belong to the same order Poaliaceae. This Malvaceae, Fabaceae, Liliaceae is not answer. Third one, Convolvulaceae and Solanaceae are the two families which are togetherly grouped in Powells as the order. Now, next question, ninth, Mangifera belongs to order Sepandels. Okay, the Malves, Powells, Sepandels and Polymenals. So answer is Sepandels, students. Mangifera belongs to the order Sepandels. So in the taxonomic systematic classification in syllabus, it is given, like for organisms where it includes the Triticum stivum and the Mangifera, Indica, Musca domestica and the humans classification, where we have done completely. The Sepandels is the order where the Mangifera, Indica belongs. Next is, the exhibits of skeletons of animals are maintained in. The exhibits of the skeletons of animals are maintained in botanical garden, zoological parks, sanctuaries, museums. So skeletons will be found mainly in the museum, students, not in zoological parks. So museum will store the specimens, insects in the insect box, skeleton system, large birds and mammals will be stored in the form of stuffed specimens. Okay, so this exhibits of a skeleton of an animal are maintained in a zoological parks. Sorry, museums. Museum is answer, students. Okay. Next is, the taxonomical aid of analytical nature is. Analytical nature, which taxonomical tool has an analytical nature? Herbarium, it just has the information as a referral it is used. Museums has the specimens where we can use it as a referral again. Then key, is what the taxonomical aid which has an analytical nature, where it has a contrasting character pair, what we call it as couplet, and every statement which comes out by using a couplet is called as lead. So answer is taxonomical aid of analytical nature is key, students. Next question is, the index of the plant species found in a particular area is provided by plant species is flora. Okay, systematics, floras, manuals, monographs. Index in the sense the complete information about one plant species in a given area is given by. So index means the namings. So here the namings information was definitely index means the information of one plant species were existing in a given area. It is given by the manual, students. The next question is, find the correct pair of plants belong to same genus but different species. Same genus but different species. Brinzel tomato, okay, they belongs to the same genus, okay, then different species. Tomato, potato, then potato and brinzel, and then potato and sweet potato. So find correct pair of plants belong to same genus but different species. The answer is potato and brinzel. So they belongs to the two different species. Solanum nigrum, what we call it as a brinzel. So here they both of them, they will be belonging to the same genus called Solanum. Solanum tubersum is the scientific name of potato. Next question is, find the genus which does not come under Solanaceae. So Solanum, Nicotina, Mangifera, Datura. Here the Mangifera indica is not going to come under the Solanaceae, students. Okay, so it is going to comes under simple Mangifera. This remaining, if you take Nicotina, Datura, they all belongs to the same genus of Solanaceae. Next question is, find the order that does not come under Dicotyledoneae. Order which will not comes under Malvaceae, Roselles, Polymenelles, Mucorales. So Mucorales is not going to comes under the Dicotyledon. Remaining orders, if you take Malvaceae, Roselles and Polymenelles, they belong to dicot plants. Next question, quick referral system in taxonomical studies is herbarium. Is answer, okay, museum, keys of florans, and computer punch card keys. So herbarium is the quick referral in taxonomical aids for referring to identify certain group of plants. This, you know, dried pressed plant parts will be there. The dried pressed and preserved plants, what we call it as herbaria, it will be stored in the systematic way according to the rules in herbarium, students. Digital herbarium provides an analogous online facility that helps in nomenclature, identification, classification and all of the above. Mainly the herbarium is used for referral for the identification, students. So question number 17, identification is the answer. So the keys are based on pairs of contrasting characters called couplets, doublet, couplet, punch cards and floras. So the pair of contrasting characters existing in a key are called couplets, students. Couplet is the answer. Next, each statement in the key is called, it is called as what? Each statement in the key is called lead. Okay, the taxon, nothing but a classification, category or a rank. Second, lead, that is what one statement coming out of the couplets which are used in as a key. Then the monograph means it has information of a single species existing in a given area. Catalog is the alphabetical arrangement of the species which are existing in given area is called as catalog, students. So answer is lead. Each statement in the key is called lead. Any unit or category in a taxonomic system is called a taxon. So classification, category or a rank is called as what, students? Taxon. What it is? Taxon, lead, key, catalog. So any unit or category in a taxonomic system is called a taxon. Next is, if two organisms are members of the same genus, they need not also be the members of the same species. So if they are belonging to the same genus, they may be of a same species, but they cannot be of a same family. In that, what we call it as hierarchy, species, kingdom, order, class, names, they may not be belonging to the same order. Okay, so if two organisms are the members of a same genus, they do not also be members of a same species, students, because two different species we will make it as an genus. Two different species we will make it as a genus. So the genus as a two species. So genus as a two species which are belonging to it. Whereas each species are different. If two organisms are the members of a same genus, they need not also be the members of same species, because the same two organisms from that genus may enter into same family or order or a class, right? So species is answer, students, here. Next question is, in a hierarchical scheme of taxonomic classification, the grouping just below the order is, so below the order, what it is present? Family, genus, phylum, and class. Just below the order we have family. Okay, so family, then order, then class, then phylum, then kingdom. That is what? Kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species is the taxonomic hierarchy, students. So the taxonomic rank which is present just below the order is family. Next, the recorded description which contain information of any one taxon, what we call it as, students? Flora, manual, catalogs, and monograph. So recorded description of which contain information of only one taxon is monograph is the answer, students. As I said, mono means single, graph is information of a single taxon, either take a species, genus, anything existing in an area of a single taxon it will consider. So keep in mind, always taxon in the sense it is not going to be only species or a genus or something. Taxon is any classification, category or rank we will consider it as a taxon. Next question is, Indian Botanical Garden is located at, so we have seen this, Lucknow, Howrah, Kew, Bangalore. So Kew is existing in London. Okay, the Howrah is the Indian Botanical Garden is located in Howrah of West Bengal. Now, Lucknow has a Indian Botanical Research Institute. The statements, nothing lives forever, yet life continues, illustrate the role of embryogenesis, monomorphogenesis, response, reproduction. So nothing lives forever, yet life continues, illustrates the role of reproduction. Organism reproduce, forms young one will develop into next group, whereas that organism will get die, but its young ones will continue to live. That is what the statement, what we call it as, nothing lives forever, yet life continues. Embryogenesis means development, students. Development of zygote into embryo. Morphogenesis means the development of larval stage to adult. Morphogenesis. Response means responding to the stimuli. Reproduction is giving birth to the young ones, students. Next, the Darwin of a 20th century is Ernst Mayr, P. Maheshwari, and the Hodgson Hooke. So Ernst Mayr is called as the Darwin of a 20th century. He is a person to give the definition of a species. Okay, so naming or grouping an organism as a species has been first started with the Ernst Mayr. So he has given the definition of a species, students. So these are the questions where you will get idea how exactly the questions will come on the topic. And this completes the first chapter, Living World and Question Discussion. Further, we will discuss in the next video, students. Thank you.